The technique of titration is the most common one, and it's the one that we will be using in order to carry out volumetric analyses. It's a technique that's used to determine what we call the equivalence point. And this is the point where the reaction has occurred as we write it. So for example, if we were to titrate sodium hydroxide against hydrochloric acid, then we would know that if we write the equation, we would get a water molecule and sodium chloride as salt, which would remain aqueous. And the mole ratio here would be 1:1:1:1. So it's this one here that is the key. What we want in our titration is to find the point where we have exactly 1 mole of sodium hydroxide with 1 mole of hydrochloric acid. So we have reached neutralization. As I mentioned earlier, in order to determine exactly where that equivalence point is, we need to select a correct indicator. Some of these will have their equivalence point at a pH around 7. In fact, this one will, because it's an example of what we call a strong acid plus a strong base. And we'll look at some more examples of these a little bit later on. So therefore, it's going to have a pH of 7. But not all acid-base reactions will have an equivalence point at 7. There are some different examples of those, and we're going to have to look at how that might affect our decision on which indicator we use. Because the reality is, most of the time we cannot find the equivalence point. It shoots through that point so fast that we actually are looking for an end point, a point to stop our titration, which is as close as practical to the equivalence point. And again, we'll have a look at some of those examples in the next of these videos. The other thing that's very important is that this technique involves some specialized glassware that we haven't used before. Of most relevance is the burette, which is a graduated piece of glassware with a very specific set of scales that allows us to be very accurate in our measurements of volume. We will also use conical flasks as our reaction vessels. We use graduated pipettes as well as devices to draw liquid into and out of those pipettes, bulbs for example. But these are all pieces of equipment that you will use when you actually go through this technique yourself in class. Practice, as I mentioned on the previous slide, is the key to this. So it's really important that you get some time to work through the technique of titration, understand what you're doing, and where those endpoints are. Good luck, and thanks for watching.